Hey guys, what's up? This is my Oneplus 5 and I bought it almost 4 years back in 2017, and as it is a pretty old phone, Oneplus has stopped giving Android updates. And I didn't get the Android 11 update on this, but I wanted it badly. So I took this as an opportunity to explore more and found EvolutionX ROM. Let's check out all its features and see how it looks like. So, starting the device, the boot animation is changed as it shows the EvolutionX logo instead of OnePlus stock boot animation. Then we get the Google logo, and then the setup is starting like Pixel. If you don't know, this ROM is basically modified version of Pixel experience. It gives you look and feel as if you are using a Pixel device, but with more features and customizations. So the setup is done and we get this Pixel-like launcher with the Evolution wallpaper. Let me reduce the brightness so that you can see the screen properly. So, if you like the stock Android experience, you are gonna love this ROM. We get the Google snapshot on the left, which shows daily events, news, etc. And the launcher is just like Google Pixel. We also get the Google Messages and Dialer app in this. And I saw a very cool feature like taking screenshot, and on-screen text selection button is available in the recent app screen. I found it very useful. Let's go to settings now, and first let me show you the Android version, which is Android 11. So as I told you before, I didn't get the Android 11 update from OnePlus. That's why I installed this ROM. Okay, now let me show you what all customizations we have here in the settings. In network and internet, almost everything is looking normal. We get VoLTE here, and also Wi-Fi calling option is there too, which was not there earlier in this phone. I don't know if it will work or not. Then there is the Evolver here, which have all types of crazy customization settings in it, but we'll come back to it later. Let's check out the display setting first. We get a live display option here. In this, we can adjust the color temperature, whether we want a warm screen or a cool one. Then in the color calibration, we can customize RGB values of the display too. Next in display setting, we get the styles and wallpapers. In this, we can customize icon style and app background styles and fonts too. Here they gave us many preset combinations, but we can create our own custom theme too by choosing font styles, icons, background color of these icons, and even background shape of the apps. Next, we have tap to wake screen feature, and then dark theme option is also there. And we can also schedule it to turn on at a specific time. Then moving to sound settings, as we get all Pixel features in this ROM, we get Pixel ringtones too. So it's good to have an overall Pixel experience, and I am liking it. Now most of the settings we have here are just normal like other phones, so I'm not gonna show you one by one. Let's move to OnePlus settings, that is something different here. So first thing we have here is DC dimming. We can turn it on to get more battery life. Then we have high brightness mode to get maximum brightness for outdoor use. Then we have panel modes. Here we can calibrate display colors to sRGB, DCI-P3 and many other presets. Also we have OnePlus mode to get default OnePlus display colors. And next we have touchscreen gestures. This is a OnePlus feature. In this we can draw a letter on screen to open an app or to do something like turning a torch, media controls, etc. It's good we are not missing out on OnePlus features here. Also, we have a FPS overlay option here too. Just in case if you are a gamer and you want to see FPS on screen, it's here for you. Now let's check out the Evolver settings. First thing we get here is the status bar. So there are a lot of customization, like we can set the position of our clock, whether we want it in middle, right or left. Then we can choose if we want AM, PM there. And also we have option to show the time with seconds too. And next we have some options to customize the battery indicator in status bar. We can choose icon style like portrait or circle or dotted circle, etc. Coming to the notifications, there are many options, like we can get a kill app button with the notification, and we can customize the battery charging light, whether we want a notification light on charging or we want a blinking light on the low battery or not. Also, we can customize the color of the light and choose any color from the color selector. Then coming to power menu setting, we have an option to add device control here to control your smart home devices directly from the power menu without opening any app. Also, we can add cards and passes here to access them quickly. Next, we have some options in gesture settings like turning on and off the torch by holding power button when screen is off. And we also have this option to turn off the screen on double tap of the status bar. Then coming to the lock screen setting, we can see the charging info like current voltage, wattage and battery temperature, and we can customize the charging animation, and there are 5 animations from which we can choose. Also, we can add media controls on the lock screen too. Next, we have navigation settings. Here we get gesture navigation option too, and also we can choose the sensitivity of the gestures here. Then I see this very nice feature to click partial screenshots. With this, we can just select a part of the screen which we want to take screenshot of. This looks good to me. Moving on to the animation settings, we get option here to disable all transitions, and then we get options of screen off animations to choose from. We get a default mode, then CRT mode, like we are turning off an old TV, and then scale mode too. And then we have many options to change animation for almost everything in this phone. It's crazy. So that's it guys for the customization. Let me show you the last feature which I like. So on the home screen, we get a 5th app icon as a suggestion app. And it is a dynamic app which gets changed according to the last app which we used. See how it's changing. And we can even get a full row of these dynamic app suggestions on the home page, which gives easy access to the most used apps. So that's it guys. This was the EvolutionX ROM for my OnePlus 5. I hope you liked this video. Please hit the like button if you did. I keep bringing new tech tips, unboxing, reviews and comparison videos for you guys. So stay connected by pressing the subscribe button down below. See you in the next one.